Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Tak pergi mana-mana pun saya.
Tutup rumah. Dah. Belum.
Belum lagi se.
Nampak.
Minta maaf OBS tak rekod suara. Aduh, lagu saja. Ada stop audio slow sikit. Okey. Alright, so mula alhamdulillah rabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala asyrafil sayidina wa mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajmain. Subhanaka la ilma illa ma 'allamtana innaka antal alimul hakim. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wahlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahil 'aliyyil 'azim. Okey, dua kali mula ni. Wala hawla wala quwwata illa billahil aliyyil azim. Alright, so apa lagi yang belum habis ya, chapter 3 ni? Okay, so kat sini kita akan cuba habiskan chapter 3, tinggal sikit lagi untuk describe 4 major type and wireless topology, WWAN, LAN, WPAN, WMAN. Asal habis dah ni kan? SSID, BSSID, ESSID, CSMA, CA, DCF, semua dah habis lah RTS kan. Tinggal yang bawah ni kan, describe key operation and key component of MANET. So tinggal yang bawah tak habis kan. Wireless network can be divided into two fundamental categories, infrastructure based and infrastructure less. Based dengan less, so yang less ni kita panggil ad hoc lah, yang macam kita buat lab 4 kamu buat Bluetooth, simple je kan. Connect.
Simple punya saya.
Okay, so LAT 5 nanti akan buat Wi-Fi pula kan, Wi-Fi direct. Tapi Wi-Fi direct ada ada device tak? Macam speaker pun tak ada kan? Eh, ada. Nama apa tu saya pakai lah? Mira.
Mirakas.
Mirakas. So Wi-Fi direct dia ada device Mirakas. Selain Mirakas apa lagi? Wi-Fi direct device. Tak ada. Mirakas saja. Macam mana kamu nak buat mirakas? Cek video. Siapa pernah pakai mirakas? Kalau beli mahal tak? Takkan kerana ni nak kena beli kan? Ni ke? Ni apa? Okay, so kalau mahal lah, mirakas nak beli mahal, puluh-puluh ringgit. So kita untuk ganti wifi device, bluetooth device ada kan? USB, bluetooth, apa lagi bluetooth? Speaker, microphone. Wifi darat, apa ni? Wifi darat, transfer data boleh kan? Daripada handphone ke komputer, komputer, okay, komputer boleh. Tapi device tak ada. So kita ganti dengan benda lain lah selain daripada wifi darat. Kalau siapa yang ada pakai, boleh tunjuk. Pakai Miracast. Ni, Anycast ke apa ni, Miracast. Tapi mahal, bawa RM89. Kamu tak mampu beli kan? Kalau siapa, rumah siapa ada TV yang latestnya tu, boleh? Pakai wifi darat kan? Dalam tu dah ada mirror siap-siap. Yang tu dah ada mirror siap-siap. TV baru lah. Okay, so satu cara lagi, tak beli mirakas, beli TV baru. Ha, itu lagi mahal. RM1,000. So, kita ganti dengan benda lain lah. Contohnya RFID. RFID. Lagi. RFID murah sikit kan? RM3 4 upang, Pak. Betul ke ni? Ha, RM10 boleh lah kan? RM10. Okay, RFID. Selain-lain daripada RFID? Paling kuat pun RFID dekat kereta ke ada kan? Touch and go pakai apa? Infrared. So infrared, murah. Okay. So janji bukan Bluetooth. Janji bukan Bluetooth, walaupun dia bukan wifi darat, kita tunjuk yang lain-lain. Okay, so and kalau ada lagi selain daripada Bluetooth dan wifi darat, kalau ada kamu name it. Kan? Zigbee ke? Zigbee pun boleh. Okay, cari Zigbee. Wallah, mahalnya. Takkan mahal macam ni kan? Okay, so saya bagi 3 dululah. Tulis siap-siap. Tulis dekat keep saya lah. Mana keep?
Boleh guna infrared tu saya.
Okay ha. ITT 575.
Boleh buat video ni tak se apa pergi kat tool lepas tu tap kat tool.
Jena. Tak faham. Dia buat lawak lah.
Infrared kan boleh buat dekat yang apa tool punya
okay.
Yang
boleh ambil gambar kat tool lah. Boleh buat video macam tu. Itu real punya kan. Lagi sampel kan. Bukannya ini. Kelas saya kat mana? Tak ada pun. Ini. Ilah illallah. Yang ni, ini personal punya kan? Nak beli apa semua. Tak apalah, tulis dekat notepad je lah. Notepad plus plus. Itu saya tulis. Lab 5 ITT 475 Wi-Fi direct and access. Okay, so file transfer antara guna Wi-Fi direct lah. Boleh. Phone dengan phone pun boleh. Phone dengan phone, phone dengan laptop ataupun laptop komputer kan. Laptop. So boleh. Mana-mana satu ataupun sekurang-kurangnya satu. Pilihlah mana-mana. Kalau lebih lagi baguslah. Dapat tunjuk diri ke lagi bagus. And then device macam tu kan, device kan, device. So Wi-Fi direct yang saya tahu Mira lah, Mira Kas. Kalau ada lagi kamu name it lah. Okay, others or butus. Okay, non bluetooth lah. Sebab bluetooth lah lab 4, lab 5 kita non bluetooth lah. RFID lagi, infrared lagi.
Sir, kalau infrared kira remote kipas boleh tak?
Ah, kena tunjuk lah.
Oh, ha, tapi boleh lah kira.
Boleh. Kipas ke? Janji nampak lah connection dia kan. Nampaklah infrared dia kan, patutnya nampak kan. Alright, so sekurang-kurangnya satu. Kalau dapat ni lagi bagus. Okay, saya tulis dulu, save. Nanti saya buat powerpoint. Baru lepas haya kan, apa tak prepare lagi. Tiba-tiba kelah kan. Let file in making. Okay habis. Yang lain ada nak tanya soalan? Tak ada? Okay, jangan risau nak submit bila. Sebab dia punya file dia pun belum siap ni. Dia punya powerpoint dia pun belum siap ni. Okay, so kita tengok sikit. Sambung tengok ke ni. Okay ya? Kamu okay ya? Tengah hari ni?
Tak.
Ngantuk ke? Tak okay?
Saya macam lagi sikit saya. Suara saya start sikit.
Alah, internet ke? Internet saya ke? Dah connected. Tapi saya harap yang recording okey kot. Yang tadi recording tak okey sebab dia ada masalah apa tau. Dia mati sebelum habis. Sebelum habis kelas. Tak apa, saya bacalah. Wireless network can be divided into two fundamental categories, infrastructure based and infrastructure less or ad hoc. So infrastructure based use fixed base station which are responsible for coordinating communication between the mobile host or nodes. For example, cellular network are infrastructure based networks built from PSTN backbone switches, MSCs base station and mobile host. Each node has its strict specific responsibility in the network. Wireless LAN typically also fall into this category. So ad hoc or infrastructureless consists of mobile nodes which communicate with each other through wireless medium without any fixed infrastructure. For example, two PCs required with wireless adapter card can set up an independent network whenever they are within range of one another. Tak okay ke? Saya tutup buat sekali lagi. Stop streaming. And screen 1.7.0. Should be better kan? Sini okey kan? Okey. Right, so kalau kata yang structure base kita pakai, infrastructure base kita pakai yang ada fixed base station ataupun pencawang kan. Infrastructure less tak pakai pencawang. So macam kita buat Bluetooth ke, nanti kita akan buat Zigbee ke apa ke. Right. So infrastructure network ada device-device banyak kan, dia connect. Yang ni adalah fix, yang ni tak ada. Dia connect macam wifi direct saja macam tu. Okay, so when do we need ad hoc network? Kenapa kita perlukan network kan? Because for example dekat disaster area, okay, so tak ada infrastructure yang available. Ataupun it's too expensive, inconvenient to set up in remote large construction site. And then there is no time to set, kan, dalam military operation. Tak done lah. Okay, try to construct a network without infrastructure using networking abilities of the participants. This is a mobile ad hoc network, a network constructed for a special purpose. Simplest example networks in a conference room, a single hop ad hoc network. Okay, so kalau boleh saya nak suruh kamu try satu benda ni. Ni bukan assignment lah. Yang ni untuk cuba-cuba je. Nanti boleh discuss apa cuba. Dengar, 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 clear?
Clear.
Lagi? Ya, tak putus-putus ke?
Tak, dah okey.
Dah okey, better daripada tadi. Okay, yang ini bukan assignment ataupun lab. Yang ini adalah suka-suka. Nama dia adalah simulator. Bukan simulator game, network simulator. Okay, so ada banyak top popular. Nak cari yang guna benda ni. Ni nak, kalau boleh kita nak guna yang ada untuk ad hoc network manage. Okay, kamu boleh google cari. Salah satu je saya boleh bagilah. Satu lagi yang selalu orang duk pakai adalah NS. NS3 ke NS2 ke belum boleh. NS3 tutorial. Yang ni ada tapi tak ada kaitan dengan manet pun ada. Top 10 most popular ni. So kamu cari yang NS3 ni. Ni extra knowledge lah. Dia benda tu hanya simulation benda atas atas skrip saja. Kamu boleh buat bagi nampak ada komputer kan. Kamu pernah tengok kena simulation tu, kamu pernah pakai apa sebelum ni? Yang ada nampak yes, packet tracer kan. Itu dah biasa kan. Okay, so so boleh try ni NS3 atau NS2. Cari yang nak simulate. Ramai orang dah buat dah. Cari file yang dia dalam bentuk script saja, dalam TCH script tak silap saya. Okay, RAM benda tu boleh nampak apa nama manet. Manet in NS3. NS2 simulation. Ada banyak ni. Okay, so kamu run dekat PC store. Bentuk dia lebih kurang macam ni je. Ah, macam ni bentuk dia. Nampak? Note 1, note 2, note 3. So kamu try run supaya dia nampak macam macam tadi tu. Macam ni. A, B, C, D. Buat 4 benda. Lepas tu run script tu kita, kamu boleh tengok dia punya konon-kononnya dia orang tengah communicate through through wireless. So nampak macam dia orang communicate dekat NS. So boleh dia simulate lah, konon-kononnya ada bacaan lah, boleh baca dia punya apa nama connection, throughput kan, delay kan, ada semua. Dia run. Right, so siapa yang dah nanti boleh discuss dengan saya. Discuss dalam kelas lah. Okay, cerita apa yang kamu run. Right, so ada banyak lah. Pakai je example dia orang. Bukan suruh buat lebih-lebih kan. Tak tahulah kalau kamu teringin, benda tu script je. Daripada 4 tukar jadi, daripada 1, 2, 3, 4 ni kamu boleh tukar jadi 4,000. Hanya guna script. Semudah 4 tu kamu tambah 0, 3, 0 belakang dia jadi 4,000 note. Macam tu. Kalau paket tracer macam mana? Macam mana nak buat 4 komputer ni? Dengar-dengar saya tak? Kedengar anak saya? Ke saya dah hilang? Sekali lagi?
Dengar, sir.
Dengar, saya ikut saya dah hilang. Okay, soalan saya, kalau paket tracer macam mana kamu nak lukis 4 ni?
Tak dengar balik.
Dengar soalan. Kalau paket tracer kamu nak simulikan 4 ni, kamu buat macam mana? Ini sini ni, laptop.
Suara rasa dengar tak dengar je, sir.
La ilaha illallah. Siapa? Tutup, tutup. Tutup, semua orang tutup. Tutup YouTube. Ini semua orang pergi kelas sekolah pun dah pergi BR tu yang salah tu. Okay kan? CPU 43. Okay, semula. Okay. Okay, baik ya? Audio okay ke? Tak okay?
Audio setakat ni okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, kalau dalam paket tracer macam mana kena kempat laptop ni, ABCD? Dekat paket tracer tu, macam command ke, drag and drop ke?
Drag and drop.
Drag and drop, kan? So, pakai drag and drop. So kalau nak buat 4,000,
copy paste
berapa kali? Copy paste sampai 4,000 kamu gandaan 202, 204, 206 gitu kan? Betul?
Betul.
1 jadi 2, 2 jadi 4, 4 jadi 8, 4 jadi 8, 8 jadi 16, kali 2 kali 2 kali 2 kan? Alright. Okay. So kalau dalam NS, kalau 4 jadi 4,000 macam mana buat?
NS tak pernah try, sir.
Kalau dekat NS 4 tu kamu, dia kan skrip. Skrip kamu tulis 3 kosong je kat belakang. 4 tu tambah 3 kosong jadi 4,000. Lepas tu run, so dia akan keluar jadi 4,000. Senang. Dah hilang dah saya punya suara. Macam tak okey nak? Yang nak okey nak? Bilang kat tangan nak? Tak ada tangan? Tak ada tangan, tak ada tangan. Memang tak okey. Saya dengar kamu pun tak okey. Kamu balas balik pun macam terputus-putus. Apa ni?
Saya tak cakap.
Terputus-putus.
Ke tak cakap?
Tapi, dia tak cakap pun tadi.
Cakap. Dia tak ada orang cakap kan? Dengan background je.
Kecak-kecak okey.
Hujan ke? Ke komputer saya haus? Komputer okey. Dan komputer tak keluar. Performa tak keluar. Okey. Tak apa, tengok recording nanti. Siapa?
InsyaAllah.
Yang mana yang boleh dengar sikit-sikit tu bertahan lagi, yang mana tak dapat nanti tengok dekat. Saya rasa recording okey lah sebab dia record offline kan, dia bukan masuk ke internet. Alright. Okay. Okay, so saya boleh select lah. Okay. Okay, so it's like hot, ad hoc network. Okay, so this is simple MANET. An ad hoc network is a local network or some other small network, especially one with wireless or connection, in which some of the networks are part of the network only for the duration of a communication session. So allows new network devices to be created. Each user has a unique network address that is like the part of the network. So dia tak sama macam Bluetooth kan, dia memang ada network address. Possible application point for such as network. So macam tadi kita kata disaster recovery, factory floor automation, call to communication. Nama dia kita panggil, bukan panggil MANET dah, kita panggil VANET lah. VANET, VANET untuk vehicle. Military networking pun ada, VANET ni banyak. Kalau kamu search banyak dia punya paper. Military networking, network centric warfare, finding out empty parking lots in a city without asking a server, pun ada. Search and rescue ataupun misi menyelamat kita tu kan. Apa? Respond team kan. Emergency respond team. So the problem or challenge for ad hoc network, without a central infrastructure, things become much more difficult. So problems are due to lack of central entity for organization available. Without a central entity like a base station, participants must organize themselves into a network self-organization. So pertains to, among others, medium access control. No base station can assign transmission resources, must be decided in a distribution fashion. So finding a route from one participant to another, okay, route pun masalah sikit. Okay, and then limited range of wireless communication. So dia punya challenge dia adalah limited range of wireless communication. For many scenarios, communication appears with peer outside immediate communication range is required. Mungkin akan ada masalah terputusan. Direct communication limited because of distance and obstacle. Alright, and then challenge mobility of participant. In many not all ad hoc network application, participant must move around. So direct communication limited because of distance obstacle. Sama atas. And then ada lagi challenge adalah battery operated entities. Ini dah pakai power bank lagi kan. In many ad hoc not all ad hoc network application, participant move around. And then energy efficient networking protocol. Sama ni macam copy paste. Sebenarnya energy efficient bukan problem. So ini yang di highlight kan. power consumption. For example, use smarty hub routes with low energy consumption. Take available battery capacity of device into account. So, mobile hub network, okay. M-A-N kat mana? M-A-H, magnet kat tidak jadi magnet kan? Ma ad hoc. Mobile ad hoc ni ma and then net networks. Okay. Do not need backbone infrastructure support. Are easy to deploy. Useful when infrastructure is absent, destroyed or impractical. Infrastructure may be not be present in a disaster area or war zone. So, move host movement frequent, topology change frequent, topology pun change. No cellular infrastructure, multi-hop wireless link, data must be routed via intermediate nodes. Right? Okay, may need a transverse, multiple link to reach destination, mobility cost, route change. Kan? Ada tunjuk ni, dia punya, ni signal dia kan? Alright, so, kalau dia tunjuk ini, dia kata nak lukis ni, dia sebenarnya lukis yang ni je. Ni cara dia nak lukis kan? Untuk mana? Kalau dia buat macam ni, maksud dia, ambil note ni, kita buat dia punya coverage je. Setiap coverage akan dapat blade yang, yang ini. Okay, so tak perlulah lukis bulat-bulat ni, kita lukis kita punya note dan juga sambungan. So kita ada managed routing protocol. Okay, ad hoc network require efficient routing protocol because the managing successful routing and decentralized environment where network propagation fluctuates is not a well defined problem and optimal route at a certain time may not work second later. Discuss below are three categories that existing ad hoc networking protocol fall into. Okay, ada table driven protocol, on demand protocol dan juga hybrid protocols. Cakap tu sebenarnya dua je, yang last tu hybrid kan. Okay, table driven protocol ada destination sequence distance vector routing DSDV, cluster head gateway switch routing CGSA, and then the wireless routing protocol WRRP. Source initiate on demand routing protocol, so ad hoc on demand distance routing AODV, dynamic source routing DSR, temporary order routing algorithm TORA, associativity based routing ABR, signal stability routing SSR, dan untuk hybrid kita pakai zone routing protocol ataupun ZRP. ZRP ni adalah hybrid. Okay. So untuk table driven routing protocol, also known as proactive routing protocol algorithm, require each node to maintain one or more table to store routing information. Each node use routing information to store the location information of other nodes in the network, and this information is then used to move data among different nodes in the network. Have lower latency since routes are maintained at all time. So the advantage is a respective amount of data for maintenance, slow reaction of resource sharing and failures. The main complexity is in generating and maintaining these routing tables. So next, on demand routing protocol establish routes only when required to route data packet. So on demand route discovery by flooding the network with route request packet have longer transmission delay. And the disadvantages, high latency time in route finding, flooding can lead to network clogging. So, untuk hybrid tadi, okay, combine proactive and reactive protocol to try and exploit their strength. So divide the zone into zones, network into zones, divide the network into zones and use one protocol within the zone and another between them. Nama-nama dia ada sini, AODV. Okay, ODV yang mana satu? On demand kan? Okay, ODV adalah on demand. So dia tak ambil semua, dia ambil semua. Contoh, okay, ODV. AODV as on demand routing algorithm in what is determined a route to a destination only when a node wants to send a packet to the that destination, it is relative to the Bell-Manfort distance vector algorithm, but is adapted to work in a mobile environment. Routes are maintained as long as they are needed by the source. AODV is capable of both unicast and multicast routing. So in AODV, every node maintains a table containing information about which neighbor to send the packet to in order to reach the destination. Sequence number, which is one of the key features of AODV, ensure the freshness of route. Route discovery mechanism is initiated when a route to new destination is needed by broadcasting route request packet ataupun RREQ. So dia ada root error RRERRR. Tadi RREQ ni RERR. Root error packet are used to erase broken link. Dia tak boleh erase sendiri kalau ada error kan, kena ada pakai benda lain. Alright, so kalau jenis ingat, kalau dia ada node ni maksudnya ada coverage. Kita boleh tengok imagine, ada coverage yang tak apa nak sampai, ada coverage yang sampai. So source RREQ, okay, nampak the neighbor intern broadcast, so tak sampai dia akan pakai yang sebelah. Okay, nampak sini ke sini tak sampai kan, so dia pakai tengah ni. Okay, dia panggil neighbors. Alright, tu ada lagi ini mana-mana pun boleh kan. So the node discard the packet that has the same source broadcast ID with a previous REQ. So ini connect, ini connect, dia nak hantar mana satu. Okay, so kalau dia tengok sama je, tengok je address sama, so dia yang kedua tu dia akan discard. So katakanlah yang ini, yang ini dulu sebelum yang tadi, so dia akan discard yang tadilah. Yang tadi pula, yang tengah ni kan, tengok siapa dululah yang ada dalam table. Right, so kat sini tengok siapa dulu sampai. Ini mungkin ini sampai sini kan, tapi yang ni lagilah laju contohnya, so dia akan sampai daripada sini. So dia akan discard satu-satu. Okay, so reply packet follow the reverse path of the route request packet recorded in broadcast packet. So itu bagi RREP. RREP ke REEP? Oh, RREP tak ada sini kan. Ada RERR untuk. Okay, so untuk path discovery in AODV, initiated when a source node needs to communicate with another node for which it has no routing info. every node maintains two counters, which node underscore sequence underscore number and then broadcast underscore ID, broadcast ID. The source node broadcast to the network a route request packet called RREQ. So structure dia macam atas ni, ada parameter source address, source sequence, number, broadcast ID, distance. If that has the same source address dengan broadcast ID, we will preview address, it drop it immediately. So they discard macam tadi kan. If a node cannot satisfy the RAQ store, destination IP, source IP, broadcast ID is as present time, used for reverse pass process and then source sequence number. So kita boleh buat reverse pass setup in which RREQ there are source sequence, the last destination sequence. So source sequence used to maintain freshness information about the reverse route to the source. Destination sequence indicate how fresh a route must be before it can be accepted by the source. As RREQ travel from source to many destination, it automatically set up the reverse pass from all nodes back to the source. But how does it work? So it's not record the address of the neighbor from which is received the first copy of the RREQ. This entry are maintained for at last enough time for the RREQ to traverse the network. And produce a reply. Right, so kat sini kita tengok contoh node S needs a route to D. S nak pergi D. Okay, so dia akan crowd route request RREQ enter BD's IP address sequence number SSSP address sequence number broadcast RREQ to neighbors untuk cari mana dia pergi D, nak pergi ke D kan. Okay, dia dah broadcast. Apa siapa yang dapat dulu? Node A receive RREQ, make reverse entry for S. A tak ada pun D, cuma dia ada B dengan C. So dia akan hantar B dengan C lah. Node C receive RREQ. Oh, node C ada kan? Node C ada D kan? It has a route to D dan dia hantar sequence dia macam mana? So kita akan create a reply, enter DP's IP address sequence number as IP address hop count unicast RIP to A. Okay, node A receive RR, dia hantar balik C, hantar balik ke A sebab C, S hantar ke A, A hantar dekat B dengan C. So C ada D, so C akan beritahu dekat A, A akan beritahu dekat S balik. So yang bawah ni akan bertukar lah. Movement on not lying along an active pass does not affect the route to that pass destination. If the source node move, it can simply reinitiate the route discovery procedure. If the destination or some immediate node move, a special RREQ is sent to the affected node. To find out node's movement predict, hello message can be used or LLAKS, okay, LLX acknowledge link layer acknowledgement for far latency. So kita kena maintain lah, dia akan maintain lah route maintenance link between C and D breaks, so node C invalid and will invalidate route to D in routing table. So node C create route error, message list all destination we are now unreachable, send an upstream neighbor yang hantar kepada upstream. Okay, node A receive RR, so ada error tu kan. Okay, check whether C is the net hook or to the route D, tengok betul tak, and then delete route D to D and forward RR. So tak semudah itu untuk dia delete kan. So node S receive RER, check whether A is net hook to route D, so delete route to D. Okay, so rediscover route still needed. Okay, yang kita tengok tadi RREQ, RREP, RE, RR. So AODV generally is node that have not participated yet in any packet exchange. ataupun kita panggil that's why in this note they are not do not maintain routine information, they do not participate in any periodic routine table exchange, then each note can become aware of other note and in its neighborhood by using local broadcast known as hello message. So neighbor routing table organized to optimize response time to local movement, provide quick response time for new routes request. So local connectivity maintenance nodes learn of their neighbor in one or two ways. Whenever a node receives a broadcast from a neighbor, it updates its local connectivity information about this neighbor. If a neighbor has not sent any packet within hello interval, it broadcasts a hello message containing its identity and its code number. So lain-lain main feature untuk AODB broadcast route discovery mechanism, not store only the routes they need, quick response to link breakage in active routes, loop free routes maintained by use of destination sequence number, scalable to large population of node bandwidth especially efficiently, cache more header information, responsive to change in network topology. Oh, habis mana? Okay, nasib baik dia tunjuk contoh hanya satu sahaja, iaitu AODB. Yang lain-lain tak tunjuk, TORA ke, SSR ke, ZRP ke. Okay, dia tunjuk hanyalah on demand tanpa ada tanpa ada infrastructure, kan? Okay, so macam mana kita nak maintain, betapa susahnya. Banyak penerangan tadi kan? So memang banyaklah, banyak penerangan betapa susahnya kita, challenges kena eka-eka ada sequence sequence number kan, ada source sequence, last destination sequence. So kena eka lah, sebab kena maintain sendiri kan, dia tak ada controller untuk nak maintain. So banyak benda tu kena, dan kita boleh create memudahkan dengan apa kita protokol-protokol yang lebih baik. Right. So itu sahaja untuk hari ni, untuk habiskan chapter 3. Nanti kita boleh start chapter 4 lah minggu ni kan, pada minggu ke 7 chapter 4, bilalah kita nak habis semua chapter, nak buat test chapter sampai chapter 5 boleh buat test kot. Test tak buat lagi chapter 7 ni. Kelas lain dah buat test lah?
Belum
lah, tak apa. Tak sempat test, kita take home test lah. Macam assignment je lah. Nak? Bagi-bagi, niru. Bagi-bagi, niru. Kalau test, kita bagi masa. Take home test, ambil ambil, minggu lepas hantar. Macam assignment. Any question? Kalau tak ada, tak apalah. So, itu sahaja.
Number 5, talking at 2.
Untuk hari ni,
Assalamualaikum, my name is Siti Khadijah binti Suki P, number 3 in the list, clock in 485.5.
So saya ambil attendance lah, kamu boleh apa nama, dismiss.
Thank
you. So tertangguh dan buat lab kamu.
IDT 575, Nur Fatiha binti Abdul Razak, number 10, 17 Mei 2019.
Okay, baik, thank
you sir. Sama. Yes. So kita tutup dengan tasbih kifarah dan surah tu, maaf.
Login for IDT 575, Lepara Aina Titi Syahir, number 9 in the list, 17 Mei 2021, 2 PM.
Okay, jangan lupa clock out lah. Assalamualaikum.
My name is Intan Swanda binti Muhammad Zaini, 17 Mei 2021,
20. Sama-sama.
Thank you.
Sama-sama.
Assalamualaikum. Clock in for IDT 575. Ini Syahra binti Alwi. Number 1, Monday 17 May 2021 at 2:01 PM.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Siti Sora binti Jabrala. Clock in for IDT 575 at 2:01 PM, number 17.
Assalamualaikum, my name is Wada Lena binti Saad, number 18 in the list. Clock in for IDT 575, 17 May 2021 at 2:01 PM.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Syamil Aikam bin Satria, number 7 on the list, clocking in for class ITT 575. Today is Monday, 17th of May at 2:01 PM. Thank you.
This is season number 4 on the list, clocking in for ITT 575 on 17 May 2021 at 2:02 PM.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Noh Azman Azman. Number 8 in the list, clock in for ITT 575 at 2:02 PM on 17th of May 2021.
Clock in for ITT 575, my name is Satin Sharam Yusuf. Number 16 on 17 May 2021 at 2:02 PM.
Assalamualaikum. Clock in for ITT 575. My name is Amir Lukman. Number on attendance list is number 3. Time is 2:03 PM.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Aziz Basirudin. Name English number 6. Clock in for ITT 575. Today is Monday, 17 May 2021 at 2:04 PM. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum, my name is Nur Hasifah binti Abu Hassan. Number 12, call in for ITT 575, 17 May 2021, 2:03 PM. Thank you.
Clock in ITT 575, my name is Nur Najihah binti Rosli. Number 11 in the list, today is Monday, 17 May 2021 at 2:04 PM.
Nurul Ain binti Amir, number 13, clock in for ITT 575, 2:07 PM, 17 May 2021.
Clock in ITT 575. My name is Nur Natasha binti Muhammad Amir Rasulillo. I'm number 14 in the list. Today is Monday, 17th of May 2021 at 2:24 PM.
This is Issa clocking up for ITT 575 at 3:05 PM, 17 May 2021.